Hey, what's up, gamers? This is Skellamistic. Welcome back to my long-awaited return and the conclusion of Zigazag. As you guys know, last time in my skeleton form, I did part two and finished up Molars, but had some problems, as you know, after that, and took me a while to get back, but here I am to finish Upper Zigazag. I'm going to go talk to Alima again.
Use the Rebus key that was obtained from Auric Nightglider to open the Duet Gate into the House of Scales.
And go and do the House of Scales. And finish this bit up finally. So go ahead and go in here. I marked this earlier so I can get back here, but apparently I'm still here anyway. It don't make a difference. At least having had to rebuild a character like I did, I had an opportunity to learn more.
No doubt a power much greater than I ushered you through the Duat Gate, mortal. I am Baruti, one of the last remaining hands of Anubis. Please tell me you're here to help.
Anyhow, as I was saying before she rudely interrupted me, I've had a chance to learn a little bit about the House of Scales, and I think I'll be able to run it a little bit easier than I even would have with my skeleton character.
The immortal Amit has loosed her army of the condemned upon the House of Scales, upsetting the natural balance.
Oh, no!
You say you seek a group of innocent Mandersouls. I saw Apep, the snaky one, hand them over to the corrupt Isfit only moments ago. Isfit was once my brother in the hands of Anubis, but now he serves Amit by preparing souls for judgment before their natural time.
Uh-oh.
But if you can reach those Mandersouls before they're judged on Anubis' scales, I can undo his work and restore their mortal states.
Okay, she can bring people back to life. That's a pretty powerful little priestess there. Wow.
Isfit has the Mandersouls, but I don't know where he hides. You'll have to wrest that information from the army of the condemned.
And by wrest, she means kick the crap out of. All right, I'm going to... Okay, these are all minions, so I'm going to use a technique that I've gotten used to. I'm going to use a speed deck for this. And here's what's in that deck. It's just Tempests, in my case. A fire would use those meteor strikes, anything that's a really fast, quick hit, your four pip spells. Anything that's fast, quick, and hard hitting, and hits the whole group. That's when I get this bunch of soldiers defeated quickly, or more quickly. Stacking it up. I've got a bunch of shadow stuff that isn't really much use in these battles, but that's alright. I'm sure one day I'll find a use for it. Whether I've got the extra shadow swords and shields or not, the gear is mighty handy to have. Alright, I could probably... Let's stack that up. Oh, you know what? Hey, there we go. Perfect timing. Shadow spell. The first time you see me use this spell in video. I stack an extra bugs in there just in case I get that shadow pick to pop up early like it just did. And boys, gee howdy, that's why.
This battle is yours, but you will not defeat the army of the condemned. Isfit prepares new recruits in the Hall of Echoes as we speak.
How special for him. No, he doesn't. He just thinks that he does.
You are too late, wizard. I've already sent the sweet little Mandersouls off to their day of judgment. Now it's your turn. I've never been fond of getting my hands dirty, though. So I'll retire to the chamber of the Sistrum and let my helpers tend to the details.
Right, another boss is gonna run away and let the minions do the work. How very Malastare of him. Come here, little Mander Mummy. There we go. I like, kind of, that fourth one takes so much time, because it gives me an extra turn. I hardly need healing. It gives me an extra turn to prep up a spell, you know, with, in this case, a critical or a blade or what have you. And there's only three of them hitting you the first turn or not hitting you. These guys don't really hit that hard at all. My personal opinion is that none of the minions in here really hit all that hard. There's, let's see, Isfit and Apep and Belosh and Amit for the bosses, and those are the only ones that really hit with any kind of gusto at all. And they don't even really hit with gusto, it's just the fact they have three helpers with them and have a lot of life. Now this technique, like I said, will work for any of the four pip fast mob spells. Unfortunately, I think life is the only one that doesn't really have a four pip fast mob spell like that. Well, let's see. Death would use probably Scarecrow, which isn't four pip, but nonetheless. Go here. Myth would use Humongo Frog. And Ice would use that Ice Storm thing that they have. Anyway, the fastest way for those mobs, those mob battles, is just to use your 4-pip fast spells. And one of the most important and fun parts of this whole silly dungeon. I happen to have a stone key. This is the door for Belosh. Belosh, quote-unquote cousin to Belloc, drops many, many fine things, including, which I'm still looking for, the Mander Palanquin, the little mouth where the Mander mummies carry around. I am dying to get that, and I do not have it yet. He also drops the motes that you need to craft the Darkmoor deck. So I'm going to do him, but before I do, another deck switch. Now, this one only has Vengeance in it, but I've made up a bunch of Tempest treasure cards ahead of time because you don't know that the number of treasure cards you have in your deck will kill Belosh. You don't know that. I mean, you could run all non-critical hits with one pip and not kill him. The trick with this guy is he's just like Belloc. You have to hit him every turn, otherwise he'll raw you. And this raw isn't as bad as the one in Azteca, but still, when he's hitting you for 400 points a turn, it eats you up pretty quick. So what I did with that deck is, I put all my actual hits and treasure cards so I can pull as many as I need when I need them, and I just have my critical wands in there. If I fill this up with Tempests, regular Tempests, I could end up with these two and this one, just basically stuff that's going to clutter up my hitting. I want to have a nice, clean, straight hit and run through him as quick as possible. So that's what I've got here. Let me go ahead and unlock it.
What strange curiosity is this? A wizard in the House of Scales? The Mander spirits could have warned you, if only you spoke ancient Mander.
And yes, if you're wondering, this is a direct ripoff of Indiana Jones.
Alive, you are worthless. But once you are no longer a threat, well, your trappings will fetch a pretty penny at the bazaar. My cousin often says he dislikes dueling with wizards, but I can't see much before my tusks to worry me.
That's okay. Let's see if you do after the battle. And the key here, getting rid of those minions quick. So again, you want your fast attack deck, but you want it altered like I've done. Okay, I will draw up my first Tempest, but I'm going to critical. I'm going to Vengeance right ahead of time. Try to get as many criticals as I can. Now, he'll raw me the first time for it, and I don't care. I'll take the first raw. But I want to have that critical up and mopping those minions out quick. And away we go. Now he's going to rob me now for not hitting him the first turn, but that's okay. as he's not going to get to do it much after that. Oh, I did, and I'm gonna. That's about half of his life, give or take. Maybe a little bit less. Maybe a third. More importantly, it cleared some of the minions out, and when I hit the next time, that third minion will be gone. I've always wondered what that spell is. He pulls that little bright glowing light out of his jacket. I don't know what that is. I'm like, that's a pretty cool little spell. Okay, and I'm gonna need to I'll get rid of one of my extra vengeance because I've got plenty of them. And just get rid of that minion and whack him again too. Every turn, you just gotta stay with him. Every turn, hit me. And wand spells will not do it. There we go, got rid of her. It, whatever. I don't think it's really a her. And we got 4,000 left. We got just about half of his life left. So I will... I've got two critical rounds left, so I'll pull up two more of these Tempests and use them. I'll use the wand spells after the critical is dead, just to build up another hit for Tempest. And sure, it wasn't a big hit, but every hit counts, and you've got to hit him every turn, and that's better than I could do with a wand. This is very easily done, if you're with a team, but as you see, I'm here solo, so I'm really kind of going over solo tactics. It's a cakewalk if you've got two other people. I know a lot of you probably, like me, like to do some of your farming by yourself. See, now he's gonna shield up. But all I'm doing is cracking a wand off and hitting him. Get rid of one more of those, draw it up, just to have it. He's shielded up, but I just happen to have that handy dandy wand that's gonna cost me no pips to hit him with to get that shield off of there. I don't care if I did big damage or not that time, but I got the shield off and did hit my hit for the turn at the same time. So I really covered a couple of purposes at the same time. And here he goes with another one. That's hard-headed right there. He's just defying me now. Okay, I'm gonna... Now I could go either way here. I could hit and take the shield out and lose some Tempest and be safe. But I think I'm gonna Vengeance again because it'll give me that extra boost for four turns. So I'll take one more of his hits. Just so that I can vengeance him with a 6-pip rather than a 4-pip or 2-pip. I've been through this Velosh guy, I don't know, 10 times. I've never gotten anything better than I think it was a deck. And even the deck wasn't all that. But he does drop some cool stuff. That Mander mount, he'll drop the moat, and he will drop some nice gear for the appropriate level. Okay, what's he got left? 1273. If I get a critical, I can finish him. If I don't, I'll have to do it next turn. There we go. There's Belosh done. Let's see what we get.
Wizard, I regret nothing.
That's what I mean, the deck. But I did get another moat.
Next
moat
time,
severity right
we
there.
Will make it.
That's the moat I was talking about, one of the ones you need to craft the Darkmoor deck. I got this deck, which is great. That's great for level 60s. But I don't really need it. Anyway, and I got a raw treasure card. I'm going to be back here off camera because I want that mount. I must have that mount. All right, let me swap back to my regular speed deck. And I will go down to the next guy, which is Isfit. And I think they call him that because he is having a fit. Constantly. Watch what he said.
You're still alive! Why is it so hard to find good help these days? Ah, fine! I'll prepare you myself!
See? He is having a fit, I think, all the time. And named him right. Plug it up. Get that out of the way. I'm not really going to waste time with that. I'll blade up for my first, and then I'll critical next. Now, I'm kind of taking advantage of Storm's high critical. A lot of people would use their personal bubble, you know, the 25%er. But I prefer the critical bubble because I hit criticals enough to make it worth having that. And I'd rather have 100% than 25%. I didn't get anything that I didn't get my critical this time either. So I will just, I don't see the need to heal. I'll just shadow for a second. I could have hit and I probably would have killed the minions, but I want to get a critical just so I can add that damage to the boss hit. Oh, you sneaky, look at him. Got rid of my blade, sneaky. That's all right. I don't even care about the blade as much as I care about getting that vengeance up. And there goes my pet. Very nice of her. Making this easier for me. That's a big old... That's an actual weapon. There's a real weapon like that that Isfit has there. But that's a cool looking weapon he's got. And there's my critical, and I will pop that up. Now, I pop up my critical, I'm more than likely going to get bugs, the shadow pit for bugs pop up. More than likely. But if I don't, I can just Tempest. Either way, the minions are gone, and Isfit's going to take a good old smack upside of his head. Either way. It seems to me that shadow pip is either do or die. It's either there right away, or it takes forever to get on there. And I haven't finished the rest of Chrysalis to get my second Shadow Pip either, so I don't have that advantage. See what I mean? Pop. I thought for sure it would come up there. Alright, now, the way this sits, this glowing squall, or glowbug squall, will hit for as much as a Tempest, or even better than a Tempest, so I'll go ahead and use it first, and then I'll Tempest. Because a glowbug will limit it, so it will hit it again. I can come back around next turn and Tempest him. And if I don't get all the rest of his life, I'll get a good chunk of it. And let's see what we get. If I critical, I'll have him. If I don't, I'll close to have him anyway. And there we go.
I give up! Please don't let Amit devour my soul! I never wanted to upset the balance! I just wanted to be important! But we can still save the Mander souls! I know a shortcut to the Hall of Justice! I will show you. Follow me!
Now, one of the things I've discovered about running this several times is that any of these bosses at any given time can drop a stone key. I didn't think that was true, but a little while ago, I had to go AFK while I was in battle with Isfit. I came back, I had a full pit bar, and I just finished it off then. But he dropped me a stone key, and that's the first time he's dropped me one. But now we know that he can. So every boss in here will drop a stone key at one time or another.
This is the longest hall, Wizard. The last walk for those on their way to their final judgment on Anubis' scales in the Hall of Justice. Oh, it appears Amit's pit vipers have infested the hall. Oh, and you'll have to defeat them to lower those venom auras.
Right.
Well, I showed you how to get to the Hall of Justice. Good luck rescuing the Mandersouls. You and I are square, right? Great, bye!
And I am now chickening out. Later. That's funny. All right, pit vipers it is.
Only a fool steps willingly into a viper's nest and expects to walk out again.
I don't see no nest. You're dead. There's the slow one over there. It took her a minute to get in. Oh, she made it, though. All right, that's fine by me. Whatever. I will crit up first. Hit him with a 6 pip critical. Now these guys, I don't know, they seem like they're amazingly tough to kill. Maybe it's because they've got a little bit more life than the other minions do. And those annoying shields don't hurt anything either, but... Wow, double shields. So that's going to be the one that lives to the last that I have to fight singly. Yeah, it's worth it. I'll blade it up. I'll blade it too. I'll have 8 pips and a blade, and I'll pretty well wipe them down. I could go with a 2 pip thing, but that's all right. These guys aren't that tough. Oh, that was a nice bolt there. And a nice weakness. Thank you very much. And that's one of the reasons for a fast deck. You avoid some of that stuff that they throw at you. Again, though, no big. Stack those Tempests up and just keep hitting them. At least they're using their pips on low-grade crap, you know, shields and blades and whatever else. Mostly. All right, let's clean some house here. I don't mind negative 20% when I get plus 100%. There we go. Thin the herd. I figured she'd live. So we just rinse and repeat. At this point, I'm down a little bit of life and I'm about to go fight Apep, and you don't really want to go into him with lower life. You can pop a potion or do what I do and go back and get the free pips. The only place in this whole foolish dungeon that there are wisps floating is in this big chamber right before Belosh. So try to conserve if you can, use them wisely. Okay, I just fill back up on that one. Well, now I've got a small amount. I've got a small amount left. I've got 3859 for my full health. I'm not going to burn that floating wisp for 15 health. That's what I'm talking about, conserving them. Because I'll have to go back, I almost guarantee you, I have to go back after Apep and get some life. This is the second hardest fight in this dungeon. Apep and then Amit. Switch decks again. in the world? Oh, I've got so many decks now, I can't tell what's going on. That's my deck right there. Let me double check it. Yep, that's the one.
We meet again, wizard. I thought about dealing with you in Lower Zigazag, but something told me fate had bigger plans for us.
Yeah, something told you to run because you were scared. He thought about dealing with me, but ran away.
Amit is preparing to judge a group of Mandasouls now. If we hurry, I'll make sure your soul is bumped to the head of the line.
See, now, if they didn't miniaturize it, I think this guy would make an excellent pet. He looks pretty, pretty cool. Standing there like he's about to blast somebody. And I got in there and snuck in that extra turn, and I got two of them that didn't get a turn. And that's what you want to try to do. Sneak in there past them. And I got my Shadow Pip on the first turn. And there is nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. If I can get 2-3 blades on there, they'll all be done. The trick to this fight, this is one of the worst fights in here. This Apep guy, if you kill off his minions, he just spawns some more. And then you got a bunch of fresh life minions, and they come back with 6 pips each. And that's a bunch of, that's a bunch of horse hockey, but they do. That's his cheat. He summons back minions, so there'll be a different school than they started with. I mean, like these will be balanced. He'll summon back some fire, or some ice, or what have you. Okay, let me see. I just put a regular blade up, so I will put up. I really want to save that Colossal for that owl, because getting 2 Shadow Pips doesn't seem like it's in the cards for me most of the time. Go ahead and do that. That's nice. They might fail my blade now. They might. It's 50-50 with those blades, literally. Oh, there we go, good, I made that cast. If you wanna make a cast, it's definitely your Bruce blades. All right, that's giving me 3, and it's looking juicy and delicious. I will Colossal that one because I can. 3 blades. Find my critical bubble and I will go for it. There's another, man. I really want to get that blade up too, that's my best blade. No pip, 40%er. Oh, good, I got it, good, good. You can almost tell if you've played this for a while if you're gonna fail or if you're not. You know what? 2 turns. I'm gonna stall it for one more, the reason being, if I manage to kill all of his minions off with the glow bugs, but I don't kill him, it'll take me 2 turns to get an owl. And in those 2 turns, he'll resummon those minions, and that's no good. So I want to kill him off with glow bug, and then try to owl him the very next turn. So I'll take a little bit of damage here, just to make sure I can do that. I think it's about 2 turns that he'll say something about prepare for cold justice or whatever, and he'll summon more minions if you've got him killed off. You really need to kill him off first. You know what, I might even do that. I might even just owl him first and then hit those minions. Now that everybody's raw spammed me. I think I'll do that, actually, I will. I'll owl him first with 3 blades, that should do the job. Well, and then I'll glow bug these minions. Glow bug without blade should kill them. That was a nice little tiny hit. He's got that shield on there, but I should, with an owl, be able to get him regardless. And even if I can't, like I said, I'll come back and glow bug and get all of them. I want to make sure I have enough pips built up to hit 2 turns in a row. Oh, I must have doubled up late and didn't realize it. But it doesn't matter. And now, I don't have to worry about him respawning, just them. Now I'll just wait for a turn and... you know what? I'll blade. I can afford two turns. They ain't gonna kill me. I always like to be sure. Even if it costs me a little bit of damage in the meantime, I like to be sure. The glow bugs will more than likely kill them. More than likely. But I wanna know that it's gonna kill them. Keep doing this. Some people play risky, some people play cautious. I'm really somewhere in between on that. Waiting for my turn. Yeah, they're not gonna kill me off. I'll be fine. Yeah, one pip and two pips, they'll be alright. He's gonna come out with that. Oh. I thought they were gonna do that natural sword attack, but I guess not. Alright, let's finish up this problem. Putting fields up. And there, plenty of damage, plenty. I probably could have gone with one blade, but that's all. Like I said, I like to be sure.
Clemency, wizard! My eternal duty is to serve,
Hammett.
I was simply following her orders.
Right.
I know when I've met my match.
You mean after I have to kick your butt, okay.
Fate must truly have grand designs for you, young wizard. Just do not be a fool and tempt her.
Alright, I could walk back and get more life wisps, but I don't want to walk that far. I'm just going to pop a potion and do the final battle. Okay, this is a good spot right here. There's Apep out of the way. There's one more battle, and that's with Ammit, which is the final boss. But I think this video is getting just a little bit long, so I'm going to end this one here, and I'll pick up the final fight in the next video. Okay, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Maybe leave me a comment about the games or other series you'd like me to play. If you want, leave a comment to talk to me, to ask me questions, or just shoot the breeze, because I'd love to talk to you guys back. This is Skeletor Mystic reminding you that whatever else you do, always love the game. Peace. Hey, what's up, gamers? This is Skellamystic. Welcome back to the second part of my run-through of the House of Scales. I am just about to fight the final battle against Ammit. And I'm not quite sure how long it's going to be. It's not that difficult of a battle, but it can get lengthy. So I decided to cut this